إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge in Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify, O believers, that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah, Rabbil Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah, have the taqwa of Allah, and don't die unless you are in a state of Islam. Dear respected brothers and sisters, we are approaching the best time during the year. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had informed us, مَا مِنْ أَيَّامٍ الْعَمَلُ الصَّالِحُ فِيهَا أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى مِنْ هَذِهِ الْعَشْرِ أي عشرة الحجة. قالوا ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله يا رسول الله قال ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله إلا رجل خرج بنفسه وماله فلم يعد بشيء من ذلك أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم advising us and informing us because he cares for us, he loves us, he wants us to compete towards forgiveness from Allah and towards Jannah. So Allah inspired him and Allah informed him about this speciality towards the end of the year of Islamic calendar, this month of Dhul Hijjah, the last month, when everybody already almost there or in their way to go to perform the Hajj. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says there is no days which is a good deed is more dearer to Allah than these 10 days. You are approaching today or tomorrow the first 10 days which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying wal fajr wa layalin ashr. Allah swear by these days. He's saying by the dawn and by the 10 days. If Allah had blessed us with Ramadan and Allah had blessed us with Laylatul Qadr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Kareem, the most generous and always dropping opportunity on us so we can have more forgiveness, more blessings and more reward. So another opportunity for the Muslims. to get more closer and nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No days which is a good deed more dearer to Allah than these 10 days. The Sahaba asked, even jihad fi sabilillah, even fighting in the cause of Allah? Listen how they ask. Listen what is very important. Neither even jihad in the cause of Allah. Because some people, they make a jihad for their desires, for their lust, for money, for oil, for authority. They said, even jihad in the cause of Allah. They said, even jihad in the cause of Allah. Not fighting because a color or a flag or a country or a president or a king. No, for the cause of Allah. Establishing the deen and the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If it takes time, you give the time. If it takes money, you give the money. If it gives your life, you give your life. Because it's for Allah, the one who gave you the life, give you the money, give you the blood, give you the air, give you everything. So if it comes about, return it back to him willingly, you will do it. Right. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, even jihad, fi sabilillah, even fighting in the cause of Allah and the good possibility of losing your life is not equal to somebody who is making dhikr, making salah, making umrah, making hajj, making tahajjud, reciting Quran in these 10 days. Wake up, Muslims! You are approaching the hijjah. He said, with only one exception, a man who left his house with his property and with his life, himself. And he didn't return back home with any of the two. That means all his money went for Allah's cause and even his life. We are not asking you to carry a sword or a machine gun. We are not asking you to kill anybody or bomb in an aeroplane or hijack an aeroplane or do any of these crazy things. We are asking you, come more to the mosque. We asking you read more Quran. We asking you get up for the hajjud, make more dua, get more closer to Allah. Is the 10 days is in. Don't let it go. Brother, I have a final exam. So make your final exam easy on yourself. Get up in a time which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes down to the lowest heaven and call it and say, anybody seeking my forgiveness? Anybody need repentance? Anybody have any needs, wants? He asking me, begging me, I will give him. It's time. Something keep here in your memory. Don't let the time, it goes fast. Next week it go like this, 10 days will go like this, and the Eid is in, and time for people to come back from Hajj. People going to make jihad by spending money, spending their time, and going away from their family and their countries. And you here can also make your own jihad. Come more to the mosque. Walk more, come more. Go visit your Muslim brothers for the sake of Allah. Give something for Allah. This is the best time for you for a good deed. Let's stop here and move before the time. Take over and let's go and see in Surah As-Saffat, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us about his beloved Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. فَأَرَادُوا بِهِ كَيْدًا فَجَعَلْنَاهُمُ الْأَسْفَلِينَ. So they plotted a plot against him, i.e. the Prophet Ibrahim, Ibrahim alayhi salam. But we made them the lowest. Get fire, candle fire, bring wood, everybody, the whole society, the whole country, against one man. Get this man that breaks the idols. Get this man that talks about La ilaha illallah tawheed. Bring him. Allah said, Wa aradu bihi kayda. They attend. They brought it against him. One verse. But what Allah said? فَجَعَلْنَاهُمُ الْأَسْفَلِينَ. We made them to be the lowest. We defeat them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had revealed and commanded the fire قلنا يا نار كوني بردا وسلاما على إبراهيم. Oh fire be cool, be safe and be secure in Ibrahim. So they plotted and Allah plotted. And any time you come against Allah or the prophets of Allah, the messenger of Allah, the awliya of Allah, the worshiping people, the masajid, the Quran, any time you cross the line of Allah and the people of Allah, Allah will make him or they to be the asfaleen. Learn. Remember, one man, the whole society against him. Allah makes him the lowest. وَقَالَ إِنِّي ذَاهِبٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي سَيَهْدِينِ. I'm going to Allah. I'm turning myself in totality to Allah. What was the dua of Ibrahim عليه السلام? رَبِّ هَبْ لِي مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Oh Allah, give me offspring. Not stop here, مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Because if you have a children, but they are not going to lay la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, you better stay without your children. If you're going to have a children to disobey Allah, so what you asking for a children for? But he said, yes, I need a child, but to be from the righteous, those who worship Allah, those their main concern is Allah, they are here to establish the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered the call of Ibrahim, فَبَشَّرْنَاهُ بِغُلَامٍ حَلِيمٍ. And we gave him the glad tidings of bearing son. We gave him the glad tidings of forbearing boy. فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَعُهُ السَّعْيَ. Allah answered the call. Allah gave you what you want. But look, when Allah gives you, you be ready for the test. Allah will test you by giving you or taking away from you. He may give it to you and take it away from you. What are you going to do? No more coffee. No more headpiece. No more salah. How is married brother and a divorce now? So what? Oh brother, I don't have a job here. So what? You going to stop making prayer? Ibrahim, the Khalil of Allah. Allah tested him. And he gave him, he answered his call. You want to, okay, we give it to you. فلما بلغ معه السعي قال يا بني إني أرى في المنام أني أذبحه فانظر ماذا ترى. Now Allah tests him in very serious matter. Not 5 weeks baby. No, when this baby and this boy became strong enough that he can walk with him, assist him and help him. So now Ibrahim is an old man and he needs, son, can you give me my cane? Son, can you pass me my keys? Now you have more concern about your child. You need his assistance because you are an old man. And the test come in very serious time. Say, oh my son, I see in my dreams that I'm sacrificing you, slaughtering you. What do you think about it? What do you say about it? Yes, the dua of the righteous people. Because he asked Allah for the righteous son. And Allah gave him a righteous son. That he doesn't say no when it comes about the obedience of Allah. When coming about serving his parents, he's ready there because he knows this is the ibadah of Allah. And he knows that his father is a messenger of Allah. And the dream that he see it is an inspiration from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ يَا أَبَتِ فَعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرْ سَتَجِدُنِي إِنْشَاءَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Oh my father, do what you've been commanded. No hallucination, no, you understand, going crazy. Some people sitting on drugs, drinking, they don't know what they're talking. I say, Allah Akbar, brother, I want to make, I'm a Muslim. No. He didn't say, what's wrong with you? You're old man, you don't know what you're talking about. He say, ya abati fa'al ma tu'mar. It's a Quran, it's hadith, it's command of Allah. So what? No negotiation, no discussion about it. Because when you are a believer, إِنَّمَا كَانَ قَوْلَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ أَنْ يَقُولُ سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. The saying of the believers, all the line, all the time, from Noah, from Adam, from everyone. And today, the saying of the believers, when you are invited for the command of Allah, the messenger of Allah, you say, we hear and obey. Ismail said, oh my father, do what you've been commanded. ستجدني والفاني إن شاء الله. اللهم أعني على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. It's not how smart you are, it's Allah to assist you, to help you to be a good Muslim. So he said, my father, do what you've been commanded, you will find me by the will of Allah. Not by my strengths, okay? But by the will of Allah, you will find me patient. Patient for what? It's a serious time for Ibrahim and for Ismail. But both of them, they're ready for the command of Allah, doesn't matter what it is. Why Ibrahim want to kill his son? It's the command of Allah. Ismail didn't make a sin, and now we have to sacrifice him so he'd be forgiven? No, it has nothing to do with salvation or original sin or born in sin. It's a test. Allah can take your life, Allah can take your money, Allah can take your job, Allah can take anything away from you, Allah can put burden in you, what you call it a burden, but it's to improve you, to make you strong, to make you a better Muslim. So do what you've been commanded. You will see me by the will of Allah. I have no choice about myself. Allah created me, and I return to Allah, and Allah tell me how to live. Not for me, how I want to live. I want to be free. Free what? Free what? You could not be free. You did not create yourself to be free. You're master. You can be free from everybody and everything except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When it comes to Allah, you have to be Abdullah. You have to be Amatullah, slave servant of Allah. Satajiduni insha'Allah min as-sabirin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continuing in Surah As-Saffat, Surah number 37 and verse 103. فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَا وَتَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِينَ. Both of them submitted to the order of Allah. Now when you come to total submission in and out, now the faraj will come. Now the exit will be open for you. Allah will make a way, but first is a test. Is a test for you. Are you going to do it or not? فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَا, both of them submitted to the order of Allah. And they about to slaughter his son again, not because he commit a sin or because that he born in sin. No, because Allah is testing him. وَنَادَيْنَاهُ أَنْ يَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ قَدْ صَدَّقْتَ الرُّؤْيَا. إِنَّ كَذَلِكَ نَجَزِ الْمُحْسِنِينَ إِنَّ هَذَا لَهُوَ الْبَلَاءُ الْمُبِينَ. Said enough, stop now Ibrahim. You already did your job. You show that you are a true believer, that you're a true submitter to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now you don't need anything to do. And verily, that indeed was a manifest trial. Nothing is a test, has nothing to do with the sin. A trial, test. Allah test us, test the believers. What else? And Allah said, and we ransom him with a great sacrifice, Iram. وَفَيْدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ. So Ibrahim, you're already dead. Now instead of this, here, sacrifice this animal, all right? And you don't have to sacrifice your son, and became the sunnah to learn how to make sacrifice for the sake of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never hurts you. You think that Allah hurting you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is strengthening you. And through hardship and difficulty, you come the strength, strong iman. You will turn to Allah. Now you're ready to make dua. Now you're ready to cry for Allah. Now you're going to stand in your feet in Qiyam al-Layl. Because this is what brings this reality of iman. And you're ready to do it. So, whenever it comes dark, become hard in you. Keep walking, and you have to have faith in your heart and know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inna ma'al usri yusra, inna ma'al usri yusra. Indeed, with the difficulties, there is ease. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa usalli wa usallimu ala al-mab'uthi rahmatan lil alameen. My dear respected brothers and sisters, in approximately 10 to 11 days, we'll be approaching the day of Eid. And why Muslims making Eid? Because Allah gives them this Eid when it comes after Hajj, after standing in Arafah. Our celebration, our festival, our happiness comes when we fulfill the order of Allah. Now we feel happy, and everybody's happy. Not a day like a day, but now you had fulfilled the command of Allah. You had went to Hajj. You have to fulfill the order of Allah. Now you finish Ramadan, you fasting, now you can have Eid. It's not every day Eid, every day music, and every day dancing, and every day going here and there and spending on a day of Eid, because a major ibadah, form of worship, been established, and that Allah had enabled you to do it. Listen to the Prophet saying in the hadith, which some of the scholars classified it to be mawquf, saying of the Sahabi, and some uplifted to be marfu' to the Prophet ﷺ, من وجد سعة فلم يضحي فلا يقربن مصلانا. Whosoever among you Muslims have means, have money, able to spend for the cause of Allah and sacrifice an animal, a sheep which is 6 months old, or a goat 1 year old, or to be a portion of one seven of a cow, which is going to be about two years, if it's a camel 5 years, and maybe mix something, but basically that you have means that you can buy this animal and you slaughter it, sacrifice it. Why? Not because of sin again. But listen to the hadith first. It's saying, don't come to our musalla. Don't come to the Eid prayer. You are not supposed to be part of the team. All of us coming to make the kbir and to say, la alhamd. You have the means to go buy, spend $150 or $200, sacrifice an animal. You can eat from it. You can give gift from it. You can give and feed the poor from it. And you are not going to do it. The Prophet ﷺ telling you shouldn't be coming to make prayer with us. He stays as a side. Who won't be like this? Can you imagine? Babe, you are the best player in the whole team. But you didn't come with your uniform. And after this, the man who been training you all this time said, yes, I love you. I care for you too much, but you could not. You know, we have all this stadium, everybody watching. You could not be fine. You can watch, you can sit here. If you got the means and you are not going to make the sacrifice, the Prophet ﷺ said, don't come near to our musalla place. We have to learn to spend in the cause of Allah. And somebody said, okay, I'm going to give $200, put it in the charity box. No, we want you to go to make a sacrifice. If you could not do it yourself, you can make somebody to go and do it for you. Don't go buy meat. Don't go buy a box of a chicken. Doesn't work. The sunnah. Revive the sunnah of the Prophet Ibrahim. وَفَدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ. Why? So we have to learn that if we have the means, each one of us have to sacrifice a sheep or a goat or 1/7 of a cow or a camel. Now again, I know the khutbah is not enough to say all this, and I have promised myself to let you be in time today, inshallah, although I have many things to tell you, especially this is the last khutbah. But inshallah, the sin has nothing to do with our sacrifice. Even in Christianity, Master, what is the salvation? He said, belief and good deed. Master, they asked Jesus, peace be upon him. He said, which way salvation, not to go to hell? He didn't say to believe in my blood. How he can be saving, and he came from a woman, if you calling everybody sinner, so your mother is sinner, and how a good can come out of a bad? Maria gave birth to Jesus, peace be upon him. So now, how is the good, the bad soil is going to give a good fruit? So, this is not. And he said, Master, what is the way to salvation? He said, believe and good deeds. He didn't say, believe in my blood. This is not. So we make sacrifice not because it's sin, but we do it appreciation for Allah giving us these cattle and sheep that we can eat, we can have milk, we can have wools, we can have jackets. Also we do with sacrifice, remembering the great sacrifice of the Prophet Ibrahim, appreciation that Allah has saved the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, great grandfather, from being killed. So there is a lot of meaning in the sacrifice, has nothing to do with sacrificing because sin, we don't believe in original sin. This is not justice. If my father do something, I come to be put in the prison for the guilt of my father. It doesn't work. And even in the Bible, it says that the father not to be killed for the son, neither the son for the father. So be careful to have this notion. This is not in Islam. Again, remember that we live in the last 10, the first 10 days of the Hijjah. You need to be more active in your ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
And you fasting?
You can fast, you can read Quran, you come to the mosque, you can all the good, any of the good deeds. Now let me tell you one thing about the sacrifice. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, man arada minkum an yudahi, fala ya'khudanna aw fala ya'khud min sha'rihi wa adhafiri. Whosoever intend, you already have intention to sacrifice, to make dhabiha in the day of Eid, do not touch your hair, do not touch your nails. That means start from today or tomorrow, you could not be shaving your head, your beard, you could not shave your beard at any time. You know it's haram, okay? We are not going to debate over this issue. We can talk about it tomorrow morning. I will give you the microphone. But now it's almost 1 minute before two. But shaving the beard is haram. But the Prophet says, if you're planning to make a sacrifice, you could not cut your fingernails, you could not shave your head, your beard, nothing. You'll be like the person in Ihram going to Hajj. So everything until you sacrifice an animal now. So if anyone after hearing the khutbah now makes the intention to make a sacrificial animal, so leave your hair, leave your beard, leave your nails. You could not come touch them or cut them. So brothers and sisters, I will tell you today on this moment, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. I love you all for the sake of Allah. I did the best to be a good imam for you. If Allah bless me to come back, this is the last khutbah for me here now. I'm leaving Monday for Hajj. If Allah bless me to come back, inshallah my intention that I bought myself, drag my body to the second gear. That means I'm ready for more work. So I hope that you make this intention that will be team when I come back, that you put it also in the third gear, not the second gear. I pray that you do this by participating more in the mosque. And I ask your forgiveness all. I still be here for 2 days more. If you have anything, any needs, whatever. Now, last minute, I want to say, the Shura had selected Brother Habibullah Abdullah to be the man in charge of the mosque. So if you have any wants, any needs, any discussion, any question, please talk to him. Brother Habibullah Abdullah. If you don't know him, you will see by the table that selling the food for the masjid, inshallah, and as well as the school. Again, I pray for those who are traveling for Hajj that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them a safe journey. And for those who are not in Hajj today, that Allah will bless them and they go for Hajj. Again, I'll be leaving. If you think I was too hard for you, alhamdulillah, I did the best, and this is called, in South Carolina, tough love. Believe it or not, this is what I have for you. I have nothing except love. It's tough, but I care for you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all, bless your families. I'm very grateful that I've been in this community, although I'm not 100% satisfied with your general contribution, but I know that you're able to do more, and inshallah, if Allah bless me, Allah blessing me, regardless if you bring me back or not, if I'm alive or dead, is a blessing because any choice of Allah, alhamdulillah. If Allah bless me to come back, inshallah, I promise I'm going to try to drag my ill body and my old age with my cane or a back press to put it in the second gear. Try to make intention that you will come and assist me in the work. This work is not mine. This mask is not mine. This organization is not mine. It's ours. And all of us have to do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah's forgiveness for me and you and all the Muslims, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with the love of the Sunnah, the love of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us better than what we are. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.
Thank you so much.
With more room in the left, as well in the reception area, please move forward. Move to the right side, brother. The last line, please. Stow. Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
one just one minute inshallah عيد